Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we're going to create out this text effect using Radial Blur option in Adobe Photoshop. We'll be creating out these three designs using Radial Blur options. In the previous video, we have seen how we can use motion blur option to create out some amazing text designs. We have also used a blending option to get some color effect. And lastly, we have used both options and create out the third design. In this tutorial, we'll be creating out these three designs using Radial Spin Blur. For the first design, we'll apply Radial Blur to the text effect, then we'll apply to a shape to create out this nice coned effect, and after that we'll apply to a text to create out this amazing text effect. So let's begin with the designing process. So to create out this first design, open a new Photoshop document. So I have already opened my Photoshop document here. The file dimension is 1500 by 1000, and it's 300 resolutions. So create a document of the same size so that you can use all the values I'm using in this tutorial. So once you have created your document file, so the first thing I'm going to do is to type out this text, and after that I will be applying a radial blur, something like this. So if I switch off the radial blur, you can see it's a simple text. After applying it's a radial blur, you'll get this simple effect. So it's very simple. So what I'll do is I'll just delete this, okay, and set your background to black. So choose black color and apply black color to your background. Now let's type out text. So add a new layer and type out XI, and I'll just fill this up with the color. So let's go there, choose some similar color, and this one like light greenish similar to this. So if you want to pick it, you can pick it from here. Similar to this, maybe a little bit brighter and a little bit greenish. Okay, so once you get your color right, I'll just place the text here, and the text I'm using for this tutorial is Add the Next, that's bold. And let's scale this up. Command Control T and just scale it up. Okay, and I'll just scale it up something around like this. So it's, I think the size is fine. Now you want to apply it, you can apply it, but before that, let's convert this into a smart object so that you can edit it later on. And now let's apply radial blur. So to apply it, go to filter, blur, and go to radial blur. In the last tutorial, we have used motion blur and create out some amazing design. In this tutorial, we'll be using radial blur. So under radial blur, you'll get two options. Blur method, there is spin and zoom. So in this tutorial we are focusing just only on spin. In the next tutorial we'll focus on zoom. We'll be creating some other designs using zoom options, so we'll talk about it later. So let's understand spin. So just check spin, and here is it. You can increase the amount here, so how much spin you want to give to your design you can set. So for this design, we'll be giving around 15, let's say, and click OK. And here we go, we got a nice spin of 15 value amounts. If you want to increase it, you can just increase it here and you'll be able to see the direction. So well, for this design, what I want is I want minimal spin blur. So let's give it around 15, and also you can move this around. Right now it's here, right? If you move to this on the other side or anywhere, you'll be able to see that you can give some different effect to your design. So what we want is we want our focal point around here so that it rotates around surrounding this point. So just double click on it and let's just place it somewhere around here. X is around here, the center point. So I'm just placing it somewhere around here just to make sure that the center point is somewhere around here, and I click OK. And here we go, and I think we can shift a little bit on the right side. So I'll just move it a little bit this side. Okay, and just click, and here we go, you've got a nice text effect here. And if you compare it with the original design, it's the same. So here we go, we have applied radial motion blur. Now let's understand how I can use this tool and create out this nice design, this cover design, cone flex. It's a simple shape, but using a radial motion blur, we have given this nice cone 3D look. So let's create this. So first of all, let's understand what's in there. So this is smart object. I'll just go in there, and here you can see it's a nice simple circle, and in that I have applied radial blur. If I reuse the radial blur, remove it, you can see it's simple gradient color, and I have applied angular gradient. So let's create this. Okay, so I'll just close this. Okay, don't save. And here I'll just delete this out. Okay, just delete this. Okay, now let's create. So first thing we're gonna do, what I'll do is I'll just create a new file. Okay, and before that, let's pick this color. This is the color we're gonna use. So the color code we're gonna use for this color is this one, E74220. So this is the color code, just copy it, okay, and click OK. Now I'll create a new document. So here's a new document, just set it, it's 1300 resolution, and create. Done. Now let's create a sphere. We can create our shape, that's a circle. So we'll go here and select ellipse tool, just click and drag and create a nice circle, right? Okay, and just scale this up just to fill up the whole area. Okay, and leave it. Here it is. Now the first thing we're gonna do is to apply the color, and we'll be applying gradient color. So go to fill and choose gradient, and under gradient we'll, here's the slider you get. On the first slide, double click on it, and here paste the color which we have copied. So Control C, Control F. So this is the color code I have copied from the previous file, E74220, and apply it. And other one, let's leave it white. Now set this like direction to angular. Okay, and let's set this somewhere around here. So let's keep it that way. So we have applied a nice gradient to this. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to apply motion blur. So now the next thing we're gonna do is to apply radial blur. So to apply it, let's convert this into smart object first. So I'll just convert this into smart object, right? And I'll just delete this background. Okay, now go to filter, blur, and radial blur. Okay, and here under radial blur, we'll adjust the amount. So we'll set it around 75, and let's click okay. And here we go. Now, as you can see, the center point is quite mixed up. It's not in the center. So we'll just go in there and make sure it's quite set in the center. Okay, something like that. It's center, and click OK. And you'll get a clean circular edge, something like this. So once you have applied motion blur, something like that, we'll convert this into smart object now. So right click, convert this into smart object, right? And now drag and drop it to our file where you want to place, and click OK. And you'll get that nice design here. Now we can just rotate it, Control T, and just make sure it's white, the brightness is on top, and I'll just place it something like this, and here center around here, and you can just scale it up according to your requirement, and enter. And here we go. And to adjust the color, you can just add a brightness and contrast adjustment layer and just snap it there and just increase the contrast a little bit. You can just do that, and you can just get this nice contrasting color to it, something like that, and it's looking great. So that's how we have created this nice cone effect using radial blur and the gradient option. Now lastly, we'll be creating out this text effect, and it's very simple. It's the same tools and same techniques. So if you check out in this tutorial, in this design, you'll be able to see that I have added a nice background that's a dark bluish tint. Then I have created a text and added a nice blur with a little bit of opacity, created another one with increased amount of radial blur, third one, and lastly I have added a text on top with a little bit of radial blur to it. So let's create this. So I'll just delete everything, okay, right, and add a new rectangular shape just for the background. So just create a background, okay, and after that let's apply some colors. So we'll go back to this, okay, radial blur. Change this to radial, okay, and for the first color, just make sure it's somewhere around here, okay. And for the second color, this slider, we're gonna keep it dark, something like this. So here we go, we have given that nice color, and here you just set the radial angle. So we're gonna increase it to around, let's say around 170 160, that's fine, and it's looking great. Now let's start designing the text effect. So the first thing we're gonna do is to type out a text. So add a new layer and just type out a text. So S-O-U-R, so fine. And this is the text I'm gonna use. This is Avenue Next, same, bold, and just reduce the size a little bit, okay, and place it somewhere around here. And I think it's fine. Now let's start creating. So I'll just create a, convert this into smart object first, to right click and convert this into smart object, and here we go, it's smart object. Now I'll just create under duplicate, okay, just hide this original one and just start applying radial blur to this. So this one selected, go to filter, blur, radial blur, Okay, and for this one we're gonna give around 25 blur. Nice. Now I'll create under duplicate of this. Just drag drop and create under duplicate, and just go and do the radial blur option, and this time increase it to 35 and click OK. After that one, I'll create under duplicate, so right click, duplicate layer, right, okay, and this will create under duplicate. Double click on it and increase this to 45 and click OK. And here we go. And now if I select all these three layers and reduce the opacity to 70%, and there we go. So if I just see over here, just unhide one by one, this, so this is the same effect which we want. And now I'll just bring this original one on top, and let's apply some color effect to this. So double click on this and open layer style panel. Here we're gonna use apply drop shadow. So just apply a drop shadow, and this one is magenta color, so you can just pick the color from here around here, and the color code is FF17A5, so just make sure it's the same color. And under here, make the opacity 100, this angular to around, so around 170 180, something like that. And after that, you're gonna add some distance, so around 11 according to this file size. And size, as you can see, if I decrease the size, it's very sharp. I want a little bit of softness, so increase around 6 or 7 maybe, and I think this looks great. Now I'll add one more shadow, and the best thing about this is you can add shadow using by just clicking on this here. So if you want to add more shadows layer, you can just click on this and it will add multiple number of shadows, right? And you can just easily delete them if you don't want them, something like this. So once you have added another layer of shadows, just click on it, drop shadow, and this will, you can just go in there and pick a color. So this time we're gonna use light blue color. So this is the color, and you can use this color code if you want to get the same color. That's 17F7FF. So click OK, and here we go. And here I have given the angular to the opposite side. For this one, magenta, I have given this around 180 and minus 180 around, and in this time I'm giving around 0, just to push it on the left side. And the distance I have pushed is around 10 or 11, and the size is around 4, or you can increase to 6. That's your choice. So 4 or 6, that's fine. And after that, click OK, and here we go. We got a nice color effect to the text. And now let's apply the radial blur. So just selecting this layer, go to filter, blur, and radial blur. And just apply a little bit of radial blur to this. So around, let's say 5, and click OK. And here we go, we have added that nice radial blur to this design. If you zoom it in, you can see that nice shaky effect to the text, and it's looking amazing. If you check out original design, we have given the same effect, that's radial blur, and we have given that nice color effect to this. So finally, we have used radial blur option in Photoshop and create out these three designs. We have applied to text, we have applied to a shape, and we have applied it to a complex text effect. So you can use this option and create out various varieties of designs. In this tutorial, we have understood how we can use radial spin blur to create out some amazing text effect. In the next tutorial, we'll be using radial zoom blur to create out some amazing design concepts. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.